time for the women's gold medal contest. And that'll be a battle between Japan and Romania. She's had that look on her face all day. It's not changed. What's she thinking? Karina Kaprioriou. Looking to upset the apple cart, because Kaori Matsumoto was a very short price favourite coming into the day, and she's made it to where she wants to be. Against the Japanese. 2010 world champion from Japan. She had to content herself with the bronze medal last year. The battle for gold in the women's under 57 kilos. Kaori Matsumoto from Japan in the white, and the Romanian Karina Kaprioriou in the blue. World championship bronze medalist last year, but this is the big one. And both of them in a situation that Nicola Fairbrother was in this time 20 years ago in Barcelona.
Yeah, nervous time. Well, Matsumoto really looking for Japan's first gold of the Olympic Games here. Unusual to get to day three without having a Japanese gold medal.
Yes, the event was first introduced at those games in Barcelona. One that Nicola won a silver medal in, up against the home favourite Miriam Blasco in the final that day. Here working for Spanish TV somewhere. Hey. Is Matsumoto the heir apparent? She isn't, then she'll be stopped by her. Kaprioriou on the left. Matsumoto in the white.
Oh, and Matsumoto's good on the ground. The Romanian knows it and stands up.
Yeah, she is. She's a titanium tip machine on the mat, old Matsumoto. She's a bit of a sweetie off it, apparently. Great personality, great company. But get her on a judo mat, and if you're facing her, you're probably in the wrong place.
The Romanian is very good at doing the counters, and Matsumoto must make sure her attacks are strong, committed. Trying to set up there with the Ashiwaza into the Sionagi.
The Romanian coach issuing instructions. You're only supposed to do that during the mates, during the little pauses, but you listen carefully, no one actually bothers with that. They're all chipping in with their tuppence worth, and if you're going to do it, then you do it in an Olympic final. Their charges need as much help as they can get as we approach the halfway point of this gold medal contest. Hey. A couple of Japanese medals so far here in London. Hiroaki Hirooka silver on the opening day, then Masashi Ebenuma's bronze yesterday, but the women so far, zero. She is desperate to put that record straight, and an entire nation back home will be watching this. Whatever the time of day, when it comes to sport, little matters more than judo.
The Japanese do have such depth in the lightweight as well. They've got not only the world number one, but often the world number two, the world number three in the 48s, 52s, 57s. But now it all rests on Matsumoto's shoulders, really, for the lightweight Japanese women to get a gold medal here. And really, for the Japanese, it's got to be gold. Anything less is just not good enough for them.
Somewhere, Capri Aurora will have a tattoo of the Olympic ring. She promised that she'd get another tattoo to add to the star that she's got somewhere on her right hand. She's going to get the rings put in place before London to bring her some decent fortune. And they've worked so far. We don't know where they are. We've not plucked up the courage to ask her. But a bit of fortune and lots of hard work have put her into this final against the Japanese favourite.
Capriura controlling the grips and almost countering the Ashiwaza there. She is a good counter fighter. She's strong and solid, and she uses her opponent's movements against them.
Matsumoto, who plans to retire after these games, that's what she said. This is it for her. She's not sure what she wants to do when she does retire. She's given herself three options: judo coach, pastry chef, astronomer. Yet to decide. I'm suspecting she's an Olympic gold medalist, then
might be judo coach.
Yeah, might be judo. Although a pastry chef sounds a decent way of spending a living. She's giving it a go here.
Yeah, she's trying to create the movement, she's trying to find the opening, and taking the Romanian back there and into the hold. The hold's been called.
Now, if she gets her to 15 seconds, she'll win the first Yuko, but it's been
the leg caught there, and she'll want to work that leg out quickly before the referee calls Mate to get the hold back on.
Meantime, look at the seconds. They're ticking away, so if she can re-establish that hold, then this might be it. The gold medal might be decided in the grappling on the mat, but it's not going to be. But that's as close as anyone's come to a score so far. Oh, she's got the point.
So the referee is discussing the throw that was happened just before the hold down.
Now, let's have a look at this while the referee and the two chair umpires have a chat. And Matsumoto is ahead by the smallest of... Oh, no, it's been rubbed out. Oh, the frustration that's she must feel.
That's a shame, really. We're so close to being a Yuko.
Over 20 seconds away from thinking she was an Olympic champion. She's got a clock on again. Into the final 10 seconds, and we're heading to another golden score. An event that is happening increasingly regularly at these Olympic Games, the 3 minutes of overtime. And that's where we're going. She may well be the overwhelming favourite, Kaori Matsumoto, but Karina Capriaryu is giving her a real run for her money here. 3 minutes, sudden death. The golden score could not be more appropriate.
Oh, launching in for the Ogoshi. Oh, an attack from behind there by the Romanian. We can't attack through the back of the legs, and the referee's going to discuss that. That's a hand sokomaki penalty for the Romanian. When your opponent turns their back on you, you can't attack through the back of their legs.
Referee inviting the chair umpires to head back to their corners.
Step out.
Oh, and she's been disqualified. Oh, what a way to lose a gold medal for Karina Capriariou. Matsumoto will not give one hoot, however. The Japanese is the Olympic champion, and the country that gave us the sport has its first gold at these games in London. And now all the tension that was locked inside can come out.
And there she is, delighted.
Just explain this for us.
Here's the penalty. You see the Romania's leg come in between. There, this is the problem. Attacking from the behind, in between the legs. Really dangerous because you can break your opponent's leg. And you can see Matsumoto looking up straight away to disqualification.
Kaori Matsumoto adds her name to a lengthy list of Japanese legends, Japanese who are Olympic champions. Oh, that's just great. They have their silver and they have their bronze, and now they've got their gold. And I wonder if that is it. I wonder if she will retire. I wonder if she is going to...
judo coach or a pastry chef?
Well, my money's still on the pastry chef. Actually, astronomer, I think. But that's only really a night job, isn't it? So she's got, she can do stuff during the day. She could do pastry chef and judo coach plus astronomy.
Yeah.
She's got to make a choice between those two, really. But
what a character, eh?
Oh, well, yeah. I mean, everybody who knows her says, well, she's an absolute monster on the mat. She's just great off it. And she's clearly got a good sense of humour.
There's the penalty at the end again. Wow. From that angle, you can see it really clearly.
Yeah, she knew. She.
Like leg there, through the back, very dangerous.
I think the Romanian knew there were no complaints from her.
Yeah. In the heat of the moment, she just attacked wrongly there.
There are plenty of Japanese flags in the arena. And they might have cause for a double celebration here. Riki Nakaya. To make him the favourite against Mansour Asayev in the men's final. The Russian fourth seed on the left-hand side. Enjoying his Olympic debut, and how he's enjoying it. And yeah, his place here by coming over the rockiest of roads, because he beat the favourite, Qi Chun Wang, along the way. So having said that, Bokiev and Elmon weren't the easiest of rides for Riki Nakaya either. Hand on the heart moment for Nakaya. You'd have just seen what Matsumoto's got up to over the last few minutes. The fight for the right to call yourself the men's Olympic lightweight champion between the Japanese Riki Nakaya in blue and the Russian Mansur Isaev. The Russian enjoying his Olympic debut. The Japanese who celebrated his 23rd birthday here in London ahead of the Games. The world champion. He was the second favourite right up to the point that Ki Chun Wang was beaten by Isaev in the semi-finals. Did that open the door wide enough though for Japan to win another gold medal, or did it just signal the fact that Isaev is the class act here today?
Isaev for me has been brilliant today. You know, he's taken out the Mongolian Sanjagal, and that shows his class. He's number four seed and one of the quality players of this division.
Both of them told to give us a contest that an Olympic final deserves, and the referee feeling in the opening 50 seconds or so, we weren't getting that. Let's work a little bit harder, please. Men's under 73 kilos, 11.5 stones. One of the four original weight categories when judo enjoyed its debut at the Tokyo Games back in 64. Gold medal stayed in Japan that day. It was won by Tachida Nakatani. And from then on, it's been a proud tradition, which Riki Nakai will know all about.
Whoa, good, brilliant. And he's on the arm. He's got the arm lock. And Nakaya trying desperately to keep his elbow turned. Whoa. The Japanese fighter doing so well to slip his elbow there.
Yeah, there was a moment of real danger.
He might have hurt his arm doing that. Asaev had that Juju Katami on.
Russians drew a blank in the judo hall 4 years ago in Beijing. They've already got a gold here on the opening day. Arsen Galstyan. Probably been busy celebrating ever since. Mansur Isaev wants to find out where he's celebrating and hopefully joining. And he's made a bright start. 2 minutes of the five played. Isaev's coach, world championship bronze in Rotterdam 3 years ago, as good as it's got pretty much for him so far. He might have had another a year later, but he just fell short. But it's almost as if everything that's happened up to this point can be erased from the hard drive if you can call yourself Olympic champion.
Uchimata, attempt at the pickup from the Russian.
It's an event, by the way, that Britain's greatest ever judo player, Neil Adams, won his first Olympic silver in Moscow, 1980. Moved up a weight in LA 4 years later to claim another silver to allow room for Kerith Brown to compete in the division in 84 and win his own bronze.
And so they're looking for the belt. Nakaya, Russian, very dangerous once he comes over the back there and onto the belt, and Nakaya knowing that, going straight for the table room of pickup.
2 minutes of regulation time to go, Nikola.
And these fighters know each other very well.
The sense that those fingertips are tipped with diamonds. Fraught with danger every time you take a step towards your opponent, but you've got to take that step to try and win the goal. But as soon as you do, you leave yourself open.
And Isaev coming off best out of that exchange. A counter to a counter. Yuko up.
Nakaya is ahead.
No, I think They've put that on the wrong side of the scoreboard.
Oh, and the Russian coach is, it's been switched.
So Saev turning that right at the end there with the Uchimata.
Just to explain that, as well as the referee in the middle and his two corner judges, there is another smartly suited bunch watching a television who can make sure that absolutely the right decision is made, and that point switch is now in the Russians' favour, and rightly so.
So again with the pickup, and now the Russian will be busy on the ground working into the last minute. Nakaya wanting the Mate break so he can get back and have another chance. Saev working for the arm lock. Nakaya now on the ground looking for the hold. Whoa, the Russian turns out.
And it gets an enormous round of applause, because in judo terms, technically what the two of them were trying to do there, that's the quality you'd have expected of an Olympic final.
So again, the pickup exchange.
Not entirely sure where Vladimir Putin is today, the Russian premier, but he's an enormous judo fan. He's a black belt. He'll be on the edge of his seat wherever he is, biting his fingernails, praying hard for Mansur Isaev.
At the last seconds here, can Isaev hold on to this score?
Chair judge takes evasive action, and it's time for Riki Nakaya to do likewise as well. Otherwise, the Japanese, who turned 23 here in London, will not be going back with a gold medal. Oh, that was very, very close to being the final nail, but it matters not. It's a second Russian gold medal in the judo hall at the start of the week. And he stands over his vanquished opponent and makes sure he knows exactly who's got the gold and exactly who's got the silver. Mansur Isaev. Well, he has beaten the two biggest names, Qichun Wang in the semis, Riki Nakaya in the final. And if you do that, then you deserve the big paycheck.
Absolutely. He's been absolutely brilliant all day. A fantastic judo from this Russian fighter.
Wait for confirmation of the result. The formalities in this most formal of sports. I suspect there's nothing formal about what his boss back home might be getting up to, jumping up and down like a loony, I suspect. The Russian premier and an entire nation celebrating another gold medal in the judo hall for Mansur Isaev.
Brilliant.
And if you ever want to see grown men cry, grown men that you wouldn't want to argue with, then the judo hall is the best place. It's the coach who's inconsolable. I was always going to win. I don't know what you were worried about. Honestly, I had it in the bag from start to finish. Not sure the coach believes him. Oh, we've seen some glorious reactions today.
What a brilliant fighter. Russian judo back at the forefront.
Back on top of the podium, and we'll be hearing that familiar anthem again very shortly.
Mr. Judo, I think all the players need another massive round of applause. Those are some fantastic finals. My name is Jamie Rickards and I shall be spending the next few minutes just going over the first session this morning and analysing what we've just seen. Now yesterday we had two Olympic, obviously, gold medalists. We had Kumman A from the Democratic People's Republic of Korea in the women's under 52 kilos and Shufa Tushvili from Georgia in the men's under 66. And today we welcome two more fantastic gold medalists. Matsumoto from Japan and Israel from Russia. Once more, show your appreciation. Right now, though, I want to go with a very good friend of mine. Let's go meet him. He is, of course, Mike Swain. Hiya, Mike. How are you doing?
How are you doing, Jamie?
I'm good indeed. I'm very good indeed. Now, listen, I just want to very quickly gloss over what we saw this afternoon. The men's finals, quite a slow start. Not many throws. The first three matches all decided on double Shido, so Yuko being awarded the other way. Was the pressure too great? Were they being too defensive?
Well, this is the Olympics, and like I said, you know, this is day three. Neil Adams and myself are exhausted because we've called every single match. We feel like we're in the match, every one of them. But the
ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the women's under 57 kilograms.
So the women's under 57 kilos medal ceremony about to get underway. The nine stoners, the lightweights, but they've given us some fabulous action today and some great stories as well. Every single one of them will have a tale now that will live with them for the rest of their lives.
Les médailles seront remises par Monsieur Léo Wollner de l'Autriche, représentant le Comité International Olympique.
The medals will be presented by Mr. Leo Wollner of Austria, representing the International Olympic Committee.
Les fleurs seront remises par Monsieur Jimmy Pedro des États-Unis d'Amérique, représentant la Fédération internationale de judo.
The flowers will be presented by Jimmy Pedro of the United States of America, representing the International Judo Federation.
He's entirely neutral, Jimmy Pedro. I suspect when he gives them to Marty Malloy, he'll also give her a great big hug. His charge,
representing France,
her bronze medal. First of the bronze medal, though, to the 23-year-old from France, and now the American, to become just the second woman from the States to win an Olympic judo medal, 4 years after Ronda Rousey finally broke the drought with her bronze in Beijing. But how much entertainment did Autumn Pavier give us? Right from the moment that she eventually saw off the challenge of Britain's Sarah Clark in the golden score right at the start of the day. Malloy started her day by upsetting the second seed, Thelma Montero. And that set her on her way to bronze. Sure, we'll see her in 4 years' time in Rio. And she's loved her moment here in London. Now, will Jimmy be able to contain himself? The answer to that is no. He gave her a big hug. Jimmy Pedro, the great American judo player. Martin Malloy, one of those who he looks after. She threw Marty Malloy for Ippon in the last 10 seconds of regular time in their semi-final to set up her bid for gold. Fell just short ultimately against Matsumoto. Not sure what her expectations were coming in at the start of the day, but very much hope that she will settle for silver because that's a fabulous effort. World Championship bronze medalist, now an Olympic silver. the winner of Japan's third judo medal at these games, but the first that is a golden one. Kaori Matsumoto, the world number one, the Olympic number one. She says she's retiring after the games. Judo coach, pastry chef, astronaut. They're her top three choices. We wait and we wonder.
Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie des vainqueurs des moins de 73 kilos hommes.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the men's under 73 kilograms.
Well, just as we've seen over the opening 3 days of this judo tournament, not necessarily the names and in the order we'd have been expecting as they make their way towards the medals podium. Those who were fancied for gold, silver and bronze by the tipsters at the start, not necessarily those that we're seeing here. Although there are some serious judo players, including the guy who's about to get the gold medal, the fourth seed, the Russian Mansur Asayev.
The medals will be presented by Mr. Patrick Bowman of Switzerland, representing the International Olympic Committee.
Les fleurs seront remises par Monsieur Sergei Soloveitchik de la Fédération de Russie, représentant la Fédération Internationale de Judo.
The flowers will be presented by Mr. Sergei Soloveitchik of the Russian Federation, representing the International Judo Federation.
Médaille de bronze représentant la France et la Mongolie.
Bronze medalist representing France, Hugo Legrand. Representing Mongolia, Niam Okur Senjago.
The Frenchman with an Olympic medal to go with his World Championship bronze. And if there's been a better smile at these games so far, then I've not seen them. And the Mongolian Nyamachir Sanjigal presses bronze to his head and then shows it to all and sundry. He's a character. He's going to have some fun tonight, I suspect. So might Hugo Legrand beat Ki Chun Wang to the bronze with a golden score.
Médaille d'argent représentant le Japon.
Silver medalist representing Japan, Rika Nakaya.
The second seed does indeed end up with the silver medal and a little flicker of a smile. But having seen the demise of the top seed, might have been expecting to be on the step just to his left. However, Riki Nakaya, who celebrated his 23rd birthday on the way to these games here in London, will head home with something a little bit more in his hand luggage. And the Russian, on his Olympic debut, is an Olympic champion. He adds to the gold won on the opening day by Arsen Galstyan. And after drawing big blanks in the judo hall in Beijing, London in 2012 has started most satisfactorily for the Russian judo team. And for Mansur Asayev in particular, well done to him.
Federation.
Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes this session at the XL. On behalf of the International Olympic Committee and the London Organising Committee for the Olympic and Paralympic Games, we hope you've enjoyed your day. Thank you for being part of London 2012. Please make your way to the exit. Upon exit, please turn left. And thank you. Have a safe journey home.